Gear 3 Dirt. In the thumbnail it already told it what it is. We had yesterday already dirt. That's two dirts in a row. And we also played an Alamo Cup at Gear 3 Dirt. Or was it even Gear 2? It was super crazy tight. It's probably enough scenery actually. Yeah, it looks empty, you could say. But there is everywhere something. And it's quite annoying. If I would ever want to build a map, it's so annoying that the map standard, the scenery standard is like so huge. Like back in the days in the old Trackmania games, such minimalistic scenery was actually a skill. Not doing much scenery and still having a nice looking map. Without overloading it. It's quite important actually. Guy in front there must be a good driver. And before it's Lars. Oh, it's Linden. Okay, I have no idea. Does he know the track? Crazy. I need to make the music even less loud because gears are quite important to hear in dirt. My budget GPS 47.6 is not good. It doesn't say what time it is. Yeah. If that is the record, then to be honest, I'll check it out. That can only help. Yeah, we have access to it, okay. I look super tight. Super tight. Pretty high. As far outside here. Outside turn. Thank you. Yeah. There are so many no steers. Granadi would be so good on this track. So many snaps. This is difficult. I forgot about this corner. Done. It's always difficult on such days where I already learned multiple tracks, in this case for the ARC, had to learn them all and get a good time on them all in just a small bit of time. It's always hard to focus for a couple of the days seeding them. Another map. It's to learn quickly and be efficient. Okay, that's decent, but it's of course not enough yet. At least I'm already there. I mean, one of the ARC maps that I hunted today was a dirt map. Yeah, it was pretty similar to this here. This is safe if I finish this. I fucked up the last turn, but it's ninth place for now. I can hope that this is a different stream. When Granati isn't there, I'm usually trying a bit more. When Granati is there, then I sometimes go pretty unfocused into the seeding. The last checkpoint as well. Okay. Eighteenth now. I have more improvement than myself. Ah, rip. And is there one more? It ends exactly when I finish. Usually it's not working out to finish this still. Naja, the title still tells about the cup of the day. Uli, thanks a lot for the sub. Nice that there were no engine sounds exactly in that part of that song. On YouTube, people, don't be confused, you have a different song. But I think at some point I have to listen to these NCS playlists that I do for the VOD. Because whenever I do clips or when I do the highlights of my videos, then I hear that music that is running there and it's so awful. I really, as in most of these no copyrights on music, I really hate it. And I guess I have to listen to the whole playlist and really sort things out. Some point I have to live listen to it and then sort things out, because I just don't want to ruin my VODs with this and my YouTube videos with music that I hate. I will have to see. The thing is that everything sounds the same as well. The NCS music. You can expect relatively close rounds already in the beginning. Elkon on orange with 2.9 behind. Was close. Oh, Harry. Really unsure with this ending here. How much to cut over the penalty? And also in the right turn before, do I want to go outside or do I just go inside? It's unclear to me there. And the world record looked so super weird with multiple counter steers and no slides and so on. Maybe I could actually no slide the full corner. Hmm. The second last checkpoint is a double respawn underground. Okay, great. So better not doing that. A 0.69! Nice. A nice time by Elkon. But not world record, right? It was faster, I think. Oh. Okay. Nice. Polo's out. Elcon 0.57, not nice. It's not nice anymore. Next to down. Ender out, Indie Driver out. I saw Indie Driver twice. Lingo is out. Spammy is out. Purple is out. And then also Inferno.
Wow.
That's a sick elimination here. Dude, another top 32. Theoretically, there's a lot possible today. If I start improving my 0.18 by a bit. If I don't, then I can go out early. You see, I was in the top 10, but that's only, it was less than half a second for a long time towards red. It quickly gets tight here. Exactly 1 second behind first is the first red. Kakne is out as well. Link und dann Kakne.
Thank you.
So now I have lost a gear for once. And that might be dangerous, I need a good ending now. Ah, luckily I'm already now in right. That doesn't mean too much though. Oh no, it doesn't mean much. Well,
how?
How is that second? Haven't made any other position. They are even catching up there behind. Yeah. I needed that luck. Like, four people must have died there as well. To be honest, this right turn is also a bit weird because I cannot see the apex. There is this yellow pool, I believe, blocking the view into it. Is this a PB with this position? It is. Next round is gonna be the most difficult because last 4KO. From 16th to 9th. Close. Oh, but good ending.
Point 18 and it was close. Oh, I told you it's the most difficult.
Okay, when I hit the ending, I make up positions, and it's another PB. But I have usually bad starts, I'm now always in red or close to red. Kinda typical, but it's always good to have a good ending. 0.13, another one close there. But every guy here has this kind of pace now. Okay, trophies and down out. Safe. Completely fucked up, but there was a crash again. I got an upper gear. Okay, the other guys were all super fast now. 0.9 or 0.0. This weird left turn that where I jump into, I struggle with. Maybe I just don't need to be outside. I got a gear issue, that's it. Yeah, but also I drove a lot of point ones, but now it got really bad in the end. I had so much of a time loss in the end because my car geared up in this last ramp transition. Otherwise I was pretty sure I could snipe again. But yeah, I definitely did something wrong in this jump. look how Shadow is driving it. It also works, you know. Okay, against Elkon he lost some time, but it also works. TA drops behind now. Oh yeah, very different lines here. Yeah, also I could have knocked out Shadow, but then I would have needed to beat Vizzy's time now. Which would require a PB, but not a big one. The others were then too fast. Oh yeah, difficult to win this. But it felt it was possible, I was just missing a line, I think. Oh, Naive has issues here. Okay. A good corner for how he entered it. But yeah, this is ripped now. He won't make it. That's a nice line by Trunu and Elkon. Oh my god. So this Trunu line is something I should have done. I did not expect Elkon to keep grip there. Ah, he has a nice entry for this. So we know Trunu goes the inside way here. And that is a nice line. He has the same exit speed, even though he went inside. This he tries everything, but wow. Yeah, this round was tough. Okay, Trunu versus Elkon. Elkon's PB we saw it was a 0.5. Trunu has done his PB previous round. Ah, he didn't get the no slide at the exit, and Elkon has also better line here. But this is a very good run for Elkon. This was not optimal, I would think. But not a part where he would lose a lot. Nice line again, it's getting tighter. But Elkon should have it. GG Elkon. Remember, in the very first round, Elkon was on orange. Or was it Lingo? I think it was Elkon, right? It could have all ended there.